stop.
Welcome to our interview channel. And today we have a special, particular, very special guest. And we decided just by coincidence to make this interview as in bed with Ralph. Okay, and maybe Ralph, I'd like maybe you to say some words to introduce yourself. I mean, thousands of people know you, but we have no.
Yeah. Okay, I make music for around 20 years. And there's the project Rastaliens, Braincell, Solar Spectrum, Unknown Reality, which is a newer one with more chiller, and I'm part of the Rave Commission as well.
Incredible, you know, I always call it Trinity, because I just do the three main project. Okay, so let's start maybe from the first one, because, well, interesting, you know, 20 years, and we're all fans of Rastaliens. So how it started in general was this project?
And he was playing bass and I was playing guitar. And at one point I ended up on a party somewhere in Germany. And I was experiencing like kind of acid stuff, acid house, techno, whatever. And I found it quite interesting, so I asked Jay to start with a project. And then at one point the band split it up and we decided, okay, let's do the electronic thing. And then we did it.
Which year it was?
93, 92, something like that. But then, like, really getting into the music was 94.
Wow.
It's a long time. And then, after a while, I started with the other project as well. And Rastaliens, we just thought about making electronic music, getting a little bit of influence from the rock stuff. And try to combine that stuff. And now we are here, still doing it and loving it. That was Braincell. I was just wanted to get my own ideas out and wanted to start my own thing, also beside the Rastaliens. And then I decided to do the Braincell one. And as we get a little bit older, after a while, I also started to do a little bit more slower music with the sort of.
Oh, we got older.
Yeah, damn it.
listening to your music, I can identify that you have some professional skills in the music by itself. Yeah. So what? How it come? You told me you play guitar, but
just yeah, I was actually I grew up playing flute and then trumpet and then an orchestra. I get all this classical stuff as a background, and then I started.
There was kind of like in the school.
I was in the school, and then later I was like having private school for guitar sessions and stuff. And but all the synthesizing we learned by ourselves, actually, just read books and going crazy with that stuff. And then years later, I was doing all the sound engineering school in Zurich, and was good, but actually I would not recommend it. It's too expensive.
So what is the present nowadays of Rastaliens Braincell? What's going on? New project, what do I expect? There is a new album with them that's coming out.
With Rastaliens, we really try to do another album. When it's coming out, I have no idea.
Where it will be released?
I have no idea.
Okay.
We just do this stuff, and there were actually a lot of people interested in releasing it, so but let's see.
You have a lot of sets and a lot of gigs in different places of the world. What do you think now is the top place for the trance parties? Strong question. Right? Like hard to choose.
That's a hard question.
Okay, let's take three. I mean, your favorite dancer in the world?
Brazil.
Okay.
And there's one special festival, it's Antares in Germany, which I love because that's amazing.
Perfect, Antares dance floor.
And I mean, Boom is big, but I like Osuna. I mean, both nice, really nice festivals. But
let's make Boom Osuna.
No, perfect.
Okay, as the festival, but as the places. Well, I mean, Trancentral is like 20 years in development now, and in some places go really push up, and some places go really down. And what do you think as the person who is traveling around the parties?
In the moment, I think Portugal is coming up again with cool parties. Brazil is like, they had their times which was not so good, but now you can feel there's some energy
again,
going. Yeah, definitely.
You say hello to Brazilian freaks.
Yes, Caipirinha rocks.
Caipirinha. Cabron.
Cabron.
Yes. That's true.
No. Why? Mexico rocks as well.
We're sure with that. A lot of Mexican freaks also.
Yeah.
Okay. And tell me something. I mean, we're from Goa anyway, so we'd like to ask a few things about Goa. Not based on your last visiting experience, but generally Goa as a place. What you can say about that?
Still one of the most awesome places for hanging around and having fun and connecting to other people. And really nice place. And always happy to be back, actually.
We're waiting you next year, you know that, no?
I'm coming.
Okay,
I'm
he's coming.
I'm coming.
You wait for the party.
I promise.
Yeah, you wait for our party with this guy, then we'll blast him. Okay, cool. So, maybe just a few words about Switzerland. Yeah, because, well, you know, we have a lot of interviews with people from different worlds, so we try to find some places and some special facts about every country. Mm-hmm. Maybe, I mean, okay, banks, Swiss knives, Swatch.
Chocolate. Cheese.
There is cheese in Switzerland?
Fucking good cheese. Come on, guys.
Okay, what else Switzerland is famous for?
Really nice.
Another Hoffman. Okay, bravo. Maestro, okay.
Good.
Sure. Okay, let's go. Your neighbor?
Nearly.
You should get one story, you know, about like one night I was going and then I see Albert and all. So it's like everybody can go in the story because they are from there. You know?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, mountains are super cool. It's very nice places. With
skiing,
snowboarding,
sure.
Whatever.
Any special food you can recommend?
If you like cheese, cheese.
Oh my god, we cannot do cheese all the time.
Raclette, cheese fondue, and then there's one is called. Wait a second. Hörnli mit Kokkerts.
Hörnli mit Kokkerts is one of my favorite, actually.
It's super nice, man. With noodles, with, again, cheese, and some mashed up meat stuff.
Are you married?
I'm married.
How is the family life?
Beautiful, actually. And she's doing...
No wife, no life.
Yeah, I would say.
Children?
Yeah, one in the moment.
How old?
3.5.
Girl, boy?
Girl, and fantastic. Very strong mind.
Yeah, fantastic. I have two also girls.
Big challenge.
It's a challenge, but it's good.
Yeah. It's also like a mirror. I mean, yeah, you can see yourself sometimes like this.
True, and it's pure love, no?
It is.
What is the secret of the long relations, especially for the person like you with this family, you know, when one is the DJ is going all the time, the other staying in the house.
Maybe. Keep it fresh, like doing a lot of different stuff and doing stuff together. And then it's hard to say, actually. It's like, it's kind of a refreshing all the time, and this keeps it quite solid. And I love her like crazy, so. And she's doing actually all the booking stuff around all the contracts and stuff, so I don't have to deal with this, and I'm really happy about it.
Maybe some words for the end of this beautiful interview with you. And first of all, yes, big respect for you to come here, to give us this music, to give us this time for this interview. All respect, we will not kiss, but we will.
Maybe later.
Okay.
And thanks actually for bringing me over. It was fucking amazing. I would stay here for months, and maybe doing an album here is a good place.
It is.
And rock on, I will come back definitely.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Thanks a lot. It was Ralph from GoaFreaks.com. My brother is a brave man.